Well, as retail meat prices remain under scrutiny by the White House, USDA recently announced $500 million to help expand small and medium-sized meat processors across the country. And while the money is meant to expand meat processing, it doesn't address another major pain point for processors, labor. And that's where the University of Missouri is now stepping in. A favorite of Columbia, Missouri carnivores is a student-run full processing facility.
So one thing that we did learn during the pandemic is that this is a nation of meat eaters, and demand was quite high.
The Mizzou meat market is a mainstay on campus, and during the COVID-19 pandemic, it became an essential source for shoppers searching for protein.
Here at the Mizzou meat market, we actually got permission to stay open as an essential business through the university. And I would argue that we probably had our best sales year ever in 2020 and into 21.
The influx of consumer demand wasn't just happening here, but at local meat processors across the state and country.
It wasn't that there wasn't product in the pipeline, but the pipeline got wrinkled up, essentially.
And as those processors continue to be pinched for labor, the state of Missouri stepped in with $20 million to help support small processors across the state struggling with funds from the CARES Act.
That effort, I would argue, was successful, and we actually took on 27 new inspected facilities in the state.
With $3 million still unused, Missouri Director of Agriculture Chris Chen asked Wiegand for ideas to put that $3 million to work, crafting a grant proposal in just 6 weeks. With one part of the grant money dedicated to upgrading equipment here, the second piece is a project still being carved out.
Ordered just yesterday, two mobile units, trailers that are self-contained for the processing plant for going out into the state, because oftentimes if you look at the personnel that we're trying to attract into the workforce, they're unemployed, underemployed.
A unique concept.
One of them is a hot dog factory on wheels.
And one that could fill many meat processors' biggest needs.
So reality is that we want to put skilled labor into these existing businesses.
And tapped to bring the idea to life is Ty Peckman, who's just 1 week in on the job.
We've taught several courses that cover a lot of the aspects from food safety to the basics of further processed meat and the principles of meat science, but it's really then how do we take this from a college course level down and do we distill it to what's essential for folks who may not come in with those background knowledge.
Peckman says the workforce development program will be practical and adaptable.
I hope it's something that's not stagnant, but ever-changing, ever-evolving.
As context will be key.
It's understanding just enough the science to why is it important that whenever we talk about humane animal handling and animal care, whenever we receive those animals, what's the importance of doing that not only from the animal well-being sake, but from the betterment of a product down the line standpoint.
It's grants like this that are pouring into the College of Agriculture, Food and Natural Resources here at Mizzou right now.
The college is up 45% in shared credit awards within the college during that pandemic cycle than they were the year prior. So 45%, a huge increase in awards coming into the college.
The dean says this specific grant is an example of how the land grant mission continues to thrive here.
It's about taking the research, the work that we do in our classrooms and in our laboratories, and taking that knowledge and taking it out state. That is truly the land grant mission.
As the custom mobile meat processing units are set to be complete by this spring, Wiegand says it'll expand beyond much more than just animal sciences.
For us, putting those on the road is going to be the first major win. And we're actually communicating with some of our community colleges and some of their workforce programs so that we can have a bigger network in the state.
As the group taps into a new tradition, the mission remains.
We need to have trained personnel in these small businesses, and they need to have staying power.
As this program shows why Mizzou Animal Science may just be a cut above the rest. The group is even working on a model to employ and train some individuals that are or have been incarcerated to help fill the labor gaps. All right, when we come back, John Phipps.
How's the weather in Europe?